All right, I want to practice with some more. So I'm going to have a number, and I want to take things away. So let's go ahead. I have 7 minus 8. Immediately, I'm like, whoops. And that 8 is bigger than the 7. So I'm going to do what? Steal from my neighbor. So I go to my neighbor's house and, oh no. They don't have anything. That's so sad. So what am I going to do? That's right. I'm going to keep going because I need some stuff. So I'm going to go to my next neighbor. All right. Does 4 have something? Mm-hmm. He's got 4. I'm going to turn it into 3. As I'm making my way back, though, oh, this poor guy had none. Let me give him a little bit. I'll turn him into 10. But I still need to borrow from him. So let's turn him into a 9 and I'll steal 1 from him. If there's a 0, you can't take from 0, so you've got to go to the next place value house. Okay, when you're heading back to where you need the 1, well, first you got to give the 100s, you got to give some to the 10s, then you borrow from the 10s in order to give to the 1s. You can't skip houses. That would be rude. Once you've found some, you need to share with a poor 0 and then go to the 1's house. So now I've got 17 minus 8. Can I do that one? Quick quiz problem. I hope you can. 17 minus 8 is 9. 9 minus 9 is 0. And 3 minus 1 is 2. When you're subtracting across zeros, that's the only part. It's still the same idea. You just have to realize when your neighbor doesn't have anything, you gotta keep moving along until you find someone who does. So when I'm trying, I have 0 things, and I'm trying to take none, well, I have nothing. I have no cookies. Do you want 9 of them? No, I have nothing, okay? So I'm going to go next door, but, oh, that's so sad. They don't have anything either. Well, let me go next door. Oh, that's so sad. They don't have anything. Do I stop? No, I keep looking. I go neighbor to neighbor to neighbor. Did I finally find some? 2 turns into 1, but now can I skip my neighbor's house? No, let me give 1 to them. This is now a 10. Can I borrow from a 10? Sure. 10 turns into 9. Give 1 to your neighbor. 10 turns into 9. And now I finally got the 1 I needed. So now I have 10 minus 9, and that is 1. When you've gone across a lot of zeros like this, I like that because all my numbers up here are now big. So look at that digit, 9. Can I do 9 minus 7? Sure. 2. 9 minus 1? Sure. 8. 1 minus nothing? Nothing. So now I'm done. 3 and 4 digits, the exact same steps. Subtraction with zeros is a little bit different, but you're still looking at your neighbor. It's just when your neighbor doesn't have anything, you go to his neighbor. And make sure you share when you're heading back. Make sense to you?